Hey, what's up everyone? Josh Quinones here, and today we are going to be installing my favorite screen protector for any device, the Whitestone Dome Glass Screen Protector. As you can see, we got full response, full clarity, full coverage, and full filling for the brand new Galaxy S22 Ultra. Like I said, this is my go-to screen protector for any device. It always does a great job at protecting those beautiful displays. And I gotta give a huge thanks and shout out to the sponsors of this video right here, Subcase. You can see they sent me some cases right here, and they were nice enough to sponsor this video because they wanna show that their cases are compatible with this screen protector right here. So you're getting the best protection possible. You're getting great protection with their cases right here. And then you're also getting some great protection for this display. So make sure you stay tuned to the end of the video because we're gonna show how these are compatible with this screen protector right here. So huge thanks to Subcase for sponsoring this video. But let's go ahead and get this installation process started. As you can see, I got everything set out and ready to go here. So if you wanna pause the video so you can see everything that you're going to need for this installation, I also got the UV light over here to the side. We are also going to need this as well, but not till the end. So I got everything set up, ready to go. The first thing we want to do is make sure these foam pads, if they're not in this rig right here, as you can see, they come out. If they're not in this rig, you want to make sure to just put those in there already so you don't forget. It will come with multiple. They actually give me pretty much like two of everything because it does come with two screen protectors. As you can see, this is a two-pack, so you will get multiple things here, but everything I have out here is just everything that we need for this specific installation. Next thing we want to do is get your device and get these black strips right here. What we're gonna do is take each black strip and just stick them around the foam. We got the top, the bottom, and both sides. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that right now. And there we are, got the black strips all the way around the phone. And basically what these do is just help prevent any of that adhesive getting in possibly any of the seams of this phone or any of the holes or anything like that, just in case it does happen to seep over the edges. These are going to help prevent that adhesive from getting inside your device. So once that's done, now we can go ahead and set it inside of our rig. Now you can actually clean your device before or after you put it in there if you want. We'll go ahead and just do this before. We got the wet little moist towelette right here. Just give it a good wipe down. Make sure it's free of fingerprints, any stains or anything like that. There we go. And then we can get our dry cloth, dry it up. There we go. And I'm gonna do the best I can here because I am doing this behind camera. Then we can just stick it in our rig, make sure it pops in there. That way it's nice and secure. And if you do happen to get extra fingerprints on there, you can just go over it again real quick just to make sure it's clean, dry it up. There we go. And then once we do that, I'm gonna go ahead and take my dust absorbing sticker and just go over the display. And you do wanna make sure you do this in a dust-free environment. Also make sure you are on a flat level surface as well, because that is going to be very important when we drop that adhesive on this display right here. But yes, if you can be in a dust-free environment, I definitely recommend that. Me, unfortunately, I am not in a dust-free environment, but I'm going to do my best here. And that looks pretty good for now. I'm gonna go ahead and set that right there. Okay, so now what we can do is we're gonna take this sticker right here. It looks like my phone kind of popped out of place. Let me pop it back in. There we go. We're good. All right. Like I said, you want to make sure it's in there nice and secure so we don't mess this up. So now we have this little sticker right here. And what this is going to do is cover that earpiece up top so no adhesive gets in there. And as you can see, it has holes in here. So you want to line it up with this part right here. That way it gets on there nice and precise. And then you can kind of just take your nail and just rub it across like that. And then once you do that, we got like this little Lego looking piece right here. As you can see, this part right here is going to stick in this top hole right there. It's gonna help hold that little sticker in place, just like that. So it's going to prevent that adhesive from getting in that earpiece. You do not wanna block that earpiece right there. Okay, so next what we want to do is take this piece up here and just stick it right up top. It's a very important part right there. Boom, just like that. As you can see, I still actually got some dust right there. Let me make sure, get that off. All right, I think we're good. Now we can take our bridge, which is right here on the bottom, and then put it in these two holes right here, just like a bridge. That's why they call it the bridge. And this part right here, this is the adhesive. So you're gonna wanna start with the colored side right here, the pink one. Go ahead and open this up. Set it right on top. Nothing's gonna come out. Set it right on top, just like that. And then once you have it set on top like that, now we can remove the black part. Now, like I said, make sure you do this in a dust-free environment. Look at it. I keep getting this one piece of dust dropping right there on the bottom. All right, I got to hurry up and do this. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and open up this top part. There we go. So you can see the adhesive has come out. I just like to usually give it a little tap, make sure it's all out. Then we can remove, ooh, guess it wasn't all out. There we go. Then we can remove this. Yeah, so just make sure it's all out. Those few drops is okay. It's not gonna mess up my installation process here. So at this point, I can now get the screen protector. Okay, again, make sure there's no dust down here or anything. I'm looking good so far. Let me just make sure. I think I see one little piece of dust right here. You really want to make sure you don't get any dust, because then that will create air bubbles under your screen protector, and you know, nobody wants that. There we go. All right, let's hurry up and do this. So I got the screen protector right here. I'm gonna go ahead and peel off the bottom piece. Make sure you put this on right. Make sure you got the curves facing the right way. I've had people tell me that they put it on backwards by accident. So you're just gonna set it like that, and it's not going to fall on your display until you take this top piece off. Now what we can do is take this little weight part right here. This is going to help spread that adhesive evenly. Boom, and it kind of gives you a little measurement as well. So this part is very important. Pay close attention to this if you've never done this before. So we're gonna put pressure right here down at the bottom. Let that adhesive slide down to this middle part right here. Once it does, that's when we're going to pull this top piece out right here. This part is very important. You gotta make sure you get it right. You don't wanna mess this up. So here we go, let's do this. Let's press down. You can see that adhesive is falling as soon as it reaches that circle. Almost there we go. I'm gonna go ahead and pull it, boom. And this weight is going to help spread it evenly among the display. So I'm gonna give it a couple minutes, let it spread out evenly, and then we'll be back to finish the rest. Okay, so it looks like everything is spread out evenly and I don't see any air bubbles, so I think we are good to go. So at this point, I'm gonna go ahead and just remove this weight right here. So you can see they give us a little part right here to pull up on so you don't mess it up. Ooh, yeah, it is looking good. All right, so at this point, we are now going to take our UV light right here. As you can see, one press will give you 15 seconds, two presses will give you 60 seconds of light. We're gonna start off with 15 seconds at the top, middle, and a bottom. So all we gotta do is just give it one press. Let me see, let me make sure, there we go. So that's gonna go for 15 seconds at the top. Okay, now 15 seconds in the middle. Now I'm not gonna let this record for the full 15 seconds and full 60 seconds. You can just pause the video here, do your 15 seconds, and then just keep watching. So this is another 15 seconds right here in the middle, and it should be ending any second now anyways. And then we'll go ahead and move it down to the bottom. Another 15 seconds. Okay, so that was 15 seconds on the top, middle, and a bottom. So what we can do now is actually take the phone out of this tray right here. Just push down on it, it'll pop right off. Now what I personally like to do before I keep moving forward, first we're gonna take these stickers off that are all around the edges. So let me go ahead and do that. Okay, so now that I got all the stickers off all around the sides, I'm gonna go ahead and take my wet cloth again and just go around just in case any adhesive did get through, which sometimes a little bit does. That's why we have these wet wipes here. Clean it up real good. There we go, and as you can see, those stickers did a good job at protecting these holes right here. Everything looks good, feels good. It doesn't look like anything dropped to the back right there. Then we'll go ahead and just dry it up all around the sides. Make sure it's nice and clean. Let's go ahead and dry up the screen protector, get my fingerprints all over it. Okay, and it's looking good. Look at that. I don't see any air bubbles, so we're looking good. So at this point, what I personally like to do to ensure that this is going to work perfectly with that in-display fingerprint sensor, right where the fingerprint sensor is, I just like to hold down for about, I don't know, maybe 20 seconds, I would say, just to ensure that it's really, really sealed right there. So when you're using that in-display fingerprint sensor, it's gonna work flawlessly, it's gonna work good. And every time I do this, in my opinion, it works good. So just apply a little bit of pressure there for a little bit. And okay, I think we're about good right there. Now we're gonna go ahead and do 60 seconds at the top, middle, and bottom. And two presses will give us that 60 seconds. So here we go. 60 seconds at the top. Okay, that was 60 seconds at the top. Let's do the middle, there we go. Okay, that was 60 seconds in the middle. And here's 60 seconds on the bottom. Like I said, I know it's going to seem like it's a lot faster than 60 seconds here in the video. Like, just make sure you press pause, do your 60 seconds, and then you can just continue with the video. I don't want to leave you, you know, sitting here in silence for 60 seconds. So we're just finishing up the last part here, 60 seconds. And then, of course, we're going to be trying it out with these cases right here. Okay, so that was 60 seconds at the top, middle, and bottom, and we should be good to go. Let me go and wipe this down real quick. Got my fingerprints right there. That way we can take a close look at this screen protector. Look at that. Looking good. I think I did a pretty good job for doing this on camera. Let's see, I got a little something down here. What is that? Okay, we're good. We're good. Now, it doesn't give full coverage around the entire camera right there. It does leave a little opening, but honestly, I mean, you can't even tell that there's a screen protector on this phone. I'm gonna go ahead and turn it on so we can test out that in-display fingerprint sensor with this screen protector right here. But before we do that, let's go ahead and test out these cases. So as you can see with the screen protector, they leave a nice little gap around the edges, the top, and the bottom, so they can be compatible with cases. But usually with bulky cases like this, it's kind of hard for these types of screen protectors to be compatible. But Subcase is saying that they do work. So let's test it out. So this is the Unicorn Beetle Pro right here. Ooh, really secure. Let's see, let's get it out. There we go. This is a two-piece case. These are all the same exact cases. I just wanted to, you know, leave these out so you can see the colors they have available. Check it out real quick. Metallic blue, one of my favorites right here. Got this nice purple right here, that Thanos purple. And this is a new one right here, that camo. Look at that. I think it looks really cool. And this one's also a new one too. They got a clear one right here. At least I've never seen this one before. And boom, just like that, the case is now on the device. Look at that, giving you that ultimate protection. And that's what the Subcase Unicorn Beetle Pro is known for, giving that maximum protection for your device. It's going to handle some really heavy drops. And I've actually done lots of drop tests with these cases on other devices, and they always do a great job at protecting my phone. And I got a video coming really soon doing a drop test with this device and these cases right here. So make sure you subscribe so you don't miss out on that video either. But definitely some very cool looking, very protective cases here for your device. They even come with the kickstand, as you can see there. If you want to watch movies or something, stand it up this way, you know. And then you can even use it as a pop socket if you want. I'm going to snap that right in there. And they all come with this holster as well, if you like, you know, holding your phone on your pants or maybe your bag or something like that. But look at this. I don't see it pushing up the edges or anything. It's looking good with this screen protector. Look at that, not looking bad at all. So you're gonna get the best protection for your display and for your entire device as well. Like I said, we got clear, we got the purple, we got blue, and then this camo color right here. And I'll have links for everything in this video down in the description below so you can check it all out for yourself. But let's go ahead and check out this in-display fingerprint sensor. Boom. Look at that. And I went ahead and registered my fingerprint sensor, or my fingerprint again, just to make sure it works even better with this. Look at that. Boom. And you can't even tell there's a screen protector on this phone. And it's going to work really, really well with that in-display fingerprint sensor. Boom. Look at that. All I got to do is just tap it one more time. Boom. Responsiveness is great. You're not going to have any problems there. So looking really, really good. I think I did a great job doing this behind camera, but this has been the Whitestone Dome Glass Screen Protector for the S22 Ultra. Again, huge thanks and shout out to Subcase for sponsoring this video. I have links for everything down in the description below. If you did like this video and find it helpful, make sure to give it a huge thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe. Hit that bell for notifications so you don't miss out on any other future videos to come. Thank you all so very much for watching. This is Josh Quinones, and I will see you all in the next one. Peace out.